You're going to start from the blue line, head to the end line, pivot to the outside, go the length of the rink, make another tight turn, and hopefully come up together and give us a couple of exciting photo finishes.
Yeah, this is going to be a little bit tougher for the players because they're going to have to take a real quick turn to come down the straightaway, and they really believe that this is going to be a good way that the fans can determine the winner of the race. We'll see what happens.
A little bit of a different twist for these two defensemen. Brian Campbell, Chris Letang will skate forward to the cones and then skate backwards the length of the rink. There they make their pivot, and then when they get down at the end again, they will turn and skate forward. This is going to be pretty close. Actually, Letang turned pretty quickly, didn't he?
Letang has some great, great edges. He moves really quick, and boy, for a little guy, he can really move. Letang just nips Campbell. Look at the extension that he has coming around this turn. You see how that quick turn right there? That is a difficult little angle to come in at. And then that final sprint to the end. And look at the smile on Soupy Campbell's face. This guy's having a blast already.
All right, now the goaltenders get a chance to do it. Jimmy Howard for the Detroit Red Wings. And Jonathan Quick, who said he was selected for this event only because his last name is Quick.
Well, I would have to give the odds here to Jonathan Quick. I've seen him skate. This guy can motor for a goalie.
And you might notice that Jimmy Howard has a camera attached to his helmet.
Yeah, we'll see how long that lasts. Yeah, you know, the guys are going to be going after that tonight.
Jonathan Quick with a slight advantage as they make the final turn.
Oh, it looks like an aircraft carrier turning down there, boys. Good job. You love the goaltenders going in the fastest skater race.
I'm down here with Christopher Letang as we watch the replay of Jonathan Quick. And what were you saying about Jonathan Quick's efforts?
Yeah, he's pretty smooth. He skated like he's got the long strides. He's got a great style, I guess.
What's the hardest part about this kind of racing?
Just to make sure you don't fail. a little bit nervous at the beginning, but once you get going, it goes away.
Thanks for your time, Chris.
Thank you.
All right, Pierre McGuire with us down at ice level as well, and he'll be getting comments from various competitors throughout the evening. And right now we're going to have the rookies from each side. Team Chara's Colin Greening, outstanding rookie from the Ottawa Senators, and Carl Hagelin apparently forgot that he had to wear a helmet for this competition.
Well, he never used to have to wear a helmet, but now with the new rules with these tight turns, this is a good opportunity for these guys to lose an edge. And with all the concussion stuff, this NHL is not going to take any chances here.
Hey, JR, I loved your scouting report on Jonathan Quick, by the way. You were bang on.
Thanks, Pierre.
Very well done.
I'm trying to emulate you, man. You're bang on in everything.
Watch Colin Greening here. This will be a great race. Cornell versus Michigan.
Yes.
Greening went to Cornell, Hagelin went to Michigan.
Oh, Hagelin got a good jump on that one. Watch him take this turn and explode. I've watched this guy all year, and this guy can motor. Look at Hagelin go. Whoa! You see that, Pierre? He almost hit the tires.
Too much speed into the turn.
Well, that's part of the reason that barrier is there, because this is the concern. How much speed these guys build up in the straightaway, JR?
Well, the power. Look at the power that Greening has coming up and coming into that Firestone tire. I'm sure that's exactly what the players are looking for. And that was a clear sprint. You see him try to reach to get the end. Look at that, right? Oh, my goodness. And then the final push. Boy, these guys got to be breathing pretty hard right now. I never wanted to do this challenge when I was going. I was playing.
Hey, JR and Dave, I'm with Carl Hagelin. What was the hardest part about that race for you?
I think just turning, it felt like I was going to fall. So, you know, you haven't skated in a while, so that's why.
When you come around that last turn, what's the best way to do it?
I think just keep your leg going. If you keep it moving, you always have a chance. And I think he kind of caught up a bit there at the end, but I think I got the win.
Thank you, you did.
All right, a couple of American-born players, one a forward, Phil Kessel, the other a defenseman, Keith Yandle. I talked to Yandle about an hour before the event. He says he knows Kessel from back when they used to try out for World Juniors together, and Yandle slipped a bit there, and that's going to give Kessel the win.
Wow, that was a close race. I think Yandle might have had him if he didn't lose an edge there. Well, this is exactly what we're talking about on that tight little turn. Here comes Yandle coming around. You know he's got looking over to see where Kessel is, and oh, a little slip, and he contains it, and just enough. Phil Kessel, he's very happy that Yandle blew a tire right there. Huh? Blew a tire.
Jeremy, is it fair to say that Phil Kessel would be one of the fastest American-born players ever, along with Pat LaFontaine?
Absolutely. This guy has jets. It's one of the reasons he's such a high-potent scorer, because he gets into the clear real quick.
Another forward versus defenseman matchup. The former Ottawa Senator, Marian Hossa, now of the Chicago Blackhawks, against Erik Karlsson. And boy, a lot of conversation about Erik Karlsson from other veteran All-Stars here. And Karlsson has the early jump.
Wow, look at the stride on Erik Karlsson go. And Hossa. Hossa's got a short little choppy stride. And Erik Karlsson just thrills the hometown fans here. God, for a defenseman, he can go.
This kid's going to be a superstar in this league for a very long time. Live legs, great skills, and he just loves drama. He just loves big theaters, JR and Dave.
Well, no question. And again, these two European skaters always have good strides. They're born and bred over there very well. And boy, look at that Erik Karlsson go.
15th overall in his draft year in the 08 draft. You have to consider that a steal for Ottawa when he went at 15.
Absolutely. Had a good year last year with 13 goals and 45 points, but he's on his way. 12-point lead over the second highest scoring defenseman in the National Hockey League. And that is Brian Campbell of the Florida Panthers, who was joking yesterday at the media availability. He said, you know, at one point I thought maybe I got a chance to lead all defensemen in points. He said, nobody's catching this kid if he stays healthy. Well, they're going back to the Hagelin and Greening competition. These are the only two that broke the 13 secondary. Now, is it when the stick crosses or is it the skate?
See, this is the big controversy in this race. It is got to be the body. It's not the stick, but you can see that last push by Hagelin. The stick gets across, and maybe the new rules might be the sticks. That's what they're talking about.
Look at this. They're changing sides, too. Hagelin started on the right side. Now he's on the left side.
So they're going to go at it again as the two fastest.
I guess I was wrong in saying Hagelin won.
Well, the reason they're going different sides, guys, is because they're both lefties. And when you're a righty or lefty, there's one power turn. One guy likes to turn to their power side, and this just gives them the equal opportunity to get one on each side.
Well, because they had the two fastest time, they're in the final anyway, so a chance to redo and figure out who is going to get the extra point for their team. Haglund's got the advantage as he gets to the blue line, and he's going to win it without any dispute.
Definitely no dispute there. Hagelin, he's got to be pretty tired right now. All the standing around the guys are doing down there. This is a hard race to do, but again, going to his power side. He's that lefty, so this is an advantage for Hagelin coming around, especially turning into the board area right there and coming down to the end. And there's no discrepancy. You're right. The stick wasn't even close, and Hagelin is the fastest skater.
Well, the Stars are continuing to light up Ottawa, and the 2012 NHL All-Star Weekend concludes tomorrow at 4 Eastern with the All-Star Game, only on the all-new NBC Sports Network. This will be an opportunity for the players on respective teams to chirp with their buddies a little bit. This is why the tweeting is so much fun, because the players that are on the bench on their respective benches participating in the tweeting will have an opportunity to express their feelings about the events as they go on here. Right now, the winning skater, Carl Hagelin, is standing by with Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Dave. Did they ever tell you why you had to redo that?
Yeah, they said that me and Greening had the fastest time, so they wanted us to go one more time to make sure who's going to get the point.